Hello guys, welcome to Life Room. My name is Manu. I am so glad that you chose to open this video. And so, in today's video, actually we are in this Christmas season. And actually we are still in the Vlogmas season. This is Vlogmas day 13. Wow. And thank God that you have come this far. 13 days of daily uploading. We have already uploaded 12 days. And so this is the 13th. Video of Vlogmas, whereby we're in this Christmas season. And I know you're out there, you're thinking, which place can I visit in Nakuru, Kenya, which is the favorite place to visit? Why should I visit Nakuru? I'm hearing people saying about, oh, Nakuru becoming a city, Nakuru is the best place to visit. Why should you visit Nakuru? And so in this video, I'm going to give you and to share with you the five places where you should actually visit in Nakuru. Five places in Nakuru that you actually need to visit this Christmas season. And so, let's dig in into the video. Let's dig in into the details of the places that you need to visit. First of all, I'm going to give my content. I found it from this website, from the website called Travelista Club. Travelista Club. I found these details from their website. And I'm just doing this just citing. I just like to cite actually where I found my content. I found them from Travelista Club. That's a website. If you need to get more information from Travelista Club website, you'll get more information about places to visit in Nakuru. And so the first place that you actually need to visit in Nakuru is Lake Nakuru National Park itself. As you can remember, I actually did this video around a month ago. I did a video where we went to Lake Nakuru National Park. I think on this I'm going to leave the link up there. We went to Lake Nakuru National Park and I was amazed that I live in Nakuru and I've never visited Lake Nakuru. And we have so many beautiful places, so many beautiful animals and so many beautiful sceneries. And so many beautiful sceneries that you're actually going to experience at Lake Nakuru National Park. First of all, the thing that actually surprised me was a waterfall. I never knew that we have a waterfall in Lake Nakuru, which is called Makalia Falls. So we have Makalia Falls, a very beautiful waterfall in Lake Nakuru. Let me now read what we get from Travelista Club. They are saying that it is one of the salty lakes in the region and is surrounded by bushy grasslands. There are over 450 bird species in this region. The park also hosts hundreds of wildlife. It is the only park in the country that has both white and black species of rhino. The white rhino and the black rhino, they are found at Lake Nakuru National Park. In addition to the rhinos, it also boasts of lions, baboons, wild beasts, spotted hyenas, buffaloes, as well as the vervet monkeys. If you want to see these beautiful animals and that beautiful waterfall and beautiful sceneries, actually there's that top cliff, a place whereby it's a cliff and you can see the lake down there, see the animals, like a beautiful scenery at Lake Nakuru National Park. And so ensure that you visit Lake Nakuru National Park as the first site that you visit as you come to Nakuru. Second place that you need to visit as you come to Nakuru is Hell's Gate National Park. I've also visited Hell's Gate National Park. We went as our church and it's a very wonderful place. On your way to Naivasha, actually it's in Naivasha. Hell's Gate National Park is in Naivasha. And it has these beautiful ridges, these beautiful, I don't know what I'm going to call them, caves and beautiful hiking places that you're going to find at Hell's Gate. I went, but I did not get the opportunity to go to the caves and the gorges, but I got the opportunity to go to the spa. They have this beautiful spa, actually a hot water spa, whereby if you're tired from walking and hiking at the gorges down there, you just come to the spa, a geothermal spa right there, and you just swim. Just have your time swimming, a very wonderful time enjoying yourself in the hot water swimming pool at Hell's Gate National Park. It also boasts of over 100 different bird species. Some of these birds include swifts, vultures, auger, buzzard, among others. The third place is Menengai Crater. I remember I've actually visited Menengai Crater, how many times? Twice I've gone to Menengai, actually thrice, I've gone there thrice, but only once did I go to Menengai Crater and down the crater. Another thing that I found about the Menengai Crater from Hivisasa, a blog written by this guy by the name Zach Abuyeka, they say that Menengai Crater is actually the second largest volcanic crater in the world, not in Kenya, the second largest volcanic crater in the world. that stands at 2,490 meters. The crater is dotted by beautiful caves, camping sites, and nature trails, which offer ideal opportunities for hiking, camping, sightseeing, and picnicking. And so, as you come to Nakuru, actually, Menengai Crater is, we can say, on the north side of Nakuru, and it is a very beautiful place that you need to visit in Nakuru with caves. There is a site that has caves. And so, as I was saying earlier, the third time that I visited Menengai Crater is the time that I went down the crater. And as they are saying, it is the second largest volcanic crater deep. It is really deep, and you actually need to visit this crater because it has wonderful scenes. If you're a hiking person, Menengai Crater is the place for you. The fourth place that you actually should visit, I'm going to generalize this, is Naivasha. Naivasha itself, the town of Naivasha, it has so many places to visit that I just chose to speak about Naivasha itself. Naivasha is one of the biggest tourist attractions in Nakuru County. Naivasha is in Nakuru. And so in Nakuru County, Naivasha itself is one of the biggest tourist attractions. When you mention the name Naivasha, many people tend to associate it with flower farming. But actually, flower farming is not the major tourist attraction in this town. Naivasha is also known for being the home of the only freshwater lake in the vast Rift Valley province. The weather in Naivasha is usually a chilly one, and as a result, you should always arm yourself with warm clothing to avoid any problems. So ensure as you come to Naivasha, you have warm clothing, and actually Naivasha is the best place to visit. I've gone to also some parts of Naivasha, to the lake, Lake Naivasha itself. Very sweet fish from Lake Naivasha, very sweet scenery, actually the best hotels. And I'm actually very sure and very proud to say that Lake Naivasha has the best hotels you will find in Kenya. It is a very small town in Nakuru County, but it has more than 20 hotels that you can actually visit in Lake Naivasha itself. Because Naivasha, it's just the best place to visit this Christmas. Some other important places that you need to visit as you visit Naivasha, some other important places that you need to visit is Crayfish. Crayfish is a hotel. I've gone there once. Fisherman's Camp, Hippo Camp, Crater Lake Camp, and Camp Canelis. Camp Canelis. Yeah, Camp Canelis. I think I said that right. And also another place that you need to visit is Mount Longonot. This is the fifth place that you need to visit as you come to Nakuru. Mount Longonot is actually... It also has a crater on top, and I've gone there this year. I think I've gone to many places in Nakuru, and so I've gone to Mount Longonot this year as well. And I went, first of all, you go up the mountain to the point where many people reach, and then many people don't continue after that point, because now continuing is going around the crater, the Longonot crater. And actually going around the crater is a longer distance than coming up the crater. I think that's what I observed and that's what I experienced. And so Mount Longonot is a beautiful, 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 actually the best beautiful hiking place that I've actually gone to. And so if you are actually a person who loves hiking, Mount Longonot is the best place that you should come hiking this year, this December, this festive season. Just come with your family, come with your friends and hike Mount Longonot. It is actually in Naivasha, just off Naivasha town, but in Nakuru actually, and also in Kenya, this is the best place. Yes, and so I am going actually to give us 6 points. The sixth one, I'll just add a sixth one, which is Lodigaton Castle. Lodigaton Castle, I've also gone there, whereby this is a big castle, actually a very beautiful, beautifully built castle, which is very old, older than me, and also older than you, because Lodigaton Castle was actually built, it was built between 1938 and 1954. It was built by Egerton himself. And so, let me read you the story about Lord Egerton. So, the castle is located 14 kilometers from Nakuru town. It was built on a 100-acre piece of land. Lord Egerton Castle built this castle for his bride to be between the periods of 1938 and 1954. It was very romantic. Yes, the castle was built using imported materials, with the help of locals and Indians. The marble that was used was imported from England and Italy. The bride-to-be refused Lord Egerton's wedding proposal. Like you can imagine, she refused. she turned down his proposal. He was giving her this big castle ever seen in Africa, but actually she refused. Lodigaton was heartbroken and as a result, never married again. He, in fact, went ahead and banned any woman from accessing the property. Today, the castle belongs to Egerton University and is always open to tourists. Actually, at this time, it is open even to the women. Initially, the women were not allowed to go to Lord Egerton Castle because after he was heartbroken by the bride-to-be, he just vowed and said that no woman should come to this premise. But these days, actually, women are allowed to come. Women, even grandmothers, everyone is allowed to the Lord Egerton Castle, including children, the elderly, adults, each and every person is allowed to Lord Egerton Castle, whereby this is a big castle with very, very many rooms, spacious rooms, like the way it was built in a, like in a majestic way, it just looks like a palace. And so I think we have a palace in Kenya. And more specifically, a palace in Nakuru. Yes. Because Lord Egerton Castle is a castle you cannot afford to miss as you visit Nakuru. That is all we had for today. I just wanted to share with you why Nakuru, why I'm this proud about Nakuru, and why Nakuru itself is the town that you should actually visit, and not a town. The city, it's in the process of becoming a city, and so the city that you should actually visit this festive season, Nakuru. Come to Nakuru, Hell's Gate National Park, Menengai Crater, Lord Egerton Castle, Lake Nakuru National Park, as we said also about Longonot, about Naivasha itself, the serene, the sceneries in Naivasha. These are the places that you shall, these are the places that you should actually visit this festive season. And not only this festive season, but anytime. I know you can be watching actually this video maybe past the festive season. Anytime that you're watching this video, Lake Nakuru. Nakuru itself is the best place that you should actually visit. Best place. Visit with your family. Visit alone. Visit with your family. Best place. Yes, and so thank you so much for watching this video. I'm so glad that you actually chose to watch our video today. And so that is the end. I'm actually thinking of now doing a video about hotels in Nakuru. I'm going to give you a video about that, the hotels that as you're visiting Nakuru, which hotels should you sleep in while in Nakuru, the best hotels. That video is coming soon, so that you cannot miss that video, ensure that you subscribe down below. Hit that notification bell so that whenever we upload, you are going to be notified. If you love this video, give it a thumbs up. Comment down below any question that you have about Nakuru that you love us to, actually the place that you love us to give you a scenery of. And as you're visiting these places, Lord Egerton Castle, Menengai Crater, as you visit these places, please just tell them that you actually saw this video from Life Probe. Mention Life Probe. Maybe I'm not assuring you that, but maybe they can give you some discount off. Yes, and so we are actually also going to do a video inside these places very soon. Yes, and so thank you so much. See you in tomorrow's video. That is Vlogmas 14, which is coming tomorrow. This is Vlogmas 13. Thank you so much. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.